Hello guys, welcome to Tech Design. This is my first video on electrical wiring and harness as well as electrical routing workbench. So before going to start today's tutorial, I'll just show you this is the content of this course. So these are the things that I'm going to explain in future videos. So please subscribe to my channel and hit the like button as well as share my videos. So if you want this content, I'll be just pasting this everything inside the description box, so you can just go and check all of them. So today's topic, I will just explain what is why electrical wiring and electrical routing, some basics that you need to understand before getting into start with the workbench. So first of all, what is a wiring harness? So a wiring harness is nothing but a group of wires and cables that can be bundled together and are routed in various configurations to transfer electricity and information and some signals that are passing through from one device to another device. So these electrical routing will be mostly used in medical industry and automotive industry and some other electronics industries as well. Okay, in this tutorial topic, as you can see here, our first will be an electrical routing and routing terminologies. So I'll just let us start the tutorial. So now we'll discuss with the terminologies that we use in electrical routing. So you can see here routing elements. So these are the components, and so this is called as a clamp, and this is some connector, and this is also we have a connector here. So these are the components, and this is a routing path. As you can see here, this is the routing path, and we have some ports. So in future, I'm just explaining why these ports are required and what are these ports and how to create these ports, how to qualify the part. So all these things I'm just going to explain in future videos, guys. So these are the routing elements we have, and also we can see here, if this is the routing path, and this we call it as a segment, and this is one segment and this is another segment, and we also have an RCPs here. So RCP is nothing but a routing control points. So if you have already routed any path, and if you want to control this, or else if you want to edit the routing, then you can just go to RCP. So this is the RCP point, so you can just modify this point to move somewhere else, so that it will modify the entire segment. And next we have different kind of ports. So you can see here, this is a fixture port. Fixture port is nothing but the port, it is a point where the routing passes through. So the routing will be passed through a fixture port. So these fixture ports and multi-port and fitting port will be qualified, and it will be inserted into a connector. So how to qualify a part and how to insert these ports and all, I'll be explaining it in future videos, guys. So now we have this multi-port here. So this multi-port is nothing but we have different connections, 9 connections or 5 connections inside the connector. So in that case, we will use the multi-port, which will be until this point we have a single path, and then it will split into multiple segments. And next we have a fitting port. Fitting port is nothing but a point where actually a routing starts. So routing path is the starting point, we call it as a fitting port. Okay, now next we have some basic electrical routing procedure we need to follow. So this is it depends on what kind of a work you are doing. If you are doing a concept design, then there will be a different kind of procedure that you will follow. If you are doing from scratch, then you will have different kind of procedure. So basically, this is basic electrical routing procedure. So in the first step, what we have to do is, there are some connections here, clamps, and then 9-pin connectors, female and male connectors. For all of them standard parts, we need to qualify that part. So that is must and should when you are working on an electrical routing. So without any qualifying standard parts, it is difficult to route a path. So it is possible, I'm not saying it is impossible, but if you have a routing qualify the part, and you have a routing ports inside the component or connectors, then it will be very easy. So first of all, we need to qualify the standard parts, and then we need to create the file, electrical routing assembly file, and then we have to properly position all the electrical components. Suppose for example, here you can see this is bracket, and then this is the connectors, and we have a different clamps here, and this is one more clamp. So these connector. So these components we need to position them properly. So because when you are if you are changing the position again, and then it will lead you to change the path as well. So before drawing any path, you just need to fix the components, and then what we have to do is create the necessary path between the electrical components. So after that you can just create a path so that you will have an segments here, and then if you want, you can just edit the path. If the routed path is not satisfactory, so you can just edit the path, and then finally you can just apply the stock. Apply the stock is nothing but you'll just give some thickness to stock, thickness to a segment. So this is all about first video, guys. This is just a basic. So in future, in the next videos, I'll just go into all these routing content. So if you have any doubt, please ask in the comment section, and also subscribe to my channel and hit a like button as well to share my videos. Thank you, guys.